Hello, welcome to Finchley College. This is a short video about calculating the bearings, whole circle bearings, along the line of a traverse. Now, as you may know, the traverse is used for creating control around a project. This is usually done by topographic surveyors who initially create a control in order to survey the site and the, everything around the site. So we as engineers, we might come into the site 2 years later, 3 years later, after the project has been going, given a go ahead to start. And one of the things that we need to do as engineers perhaps is to check the existing controls, make sure A, they haven't moved, or B, we haven't used a wrong name. So a simple procedure is that we'll draw the sketch of the point, the control points. We start at the first point, and we number them in anti-clockwise direction. So we start the first one as 1, we go anti-clockwise 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then back to 1. The traverse could be a different number, it could be 7, 8, 9 stations, or could be less. It doesn't matter. We start from 1, we go around until we get to the last. Now, we're going to start writing it in this manner. So we start the bearing from 1 to 6. In this case, x-axis, I'm going to assume the bearing is 0 degrees. You might be given that bearing, which in that case you will write the number you've been given, or we'll assume for this exercise is 0 degrees. So then we want to calculate the bearing from 1 to 2, and that is this 0 degrees plus 148 degrees that we have turned. Therefore, the bearing from 1 to 2 is 148 degrees, same as this angle. Then the bearing from 2 to 1 will be plus 180, because bearing along a straight line is always 180 different. So we write the numbers 1 to 6, 0 degrees, 1 to 2 is plus the angle at 1, which is in this case 148, plus 180, then plus the angle at 2, then plus 180, then plus angle at 3, plus 180, plus the angle at 4, plus 180, plus the angle at 5, plus 180, and so on. So we start simply the first bearing from the first to the last, the one on the left. Then you add the angle at the first station. Then you add 180, and you continue adding the angles and 180. So for this one, the angle at from 1 to 6 is 0 degrees. Angle from 1 to 2 is 148 degrees. From 2 to 1, 3 to 8 degrees. So we just add them all up. Plus 94, 42, plus 180, 602. Plus, this is the bearing that's written right from 3 to 4, 7 to 7. 4 to 3, 907. So you can leave the bearings as they are, or you can subtract if they exceed 360. Because the angles are only from 0 to 360, you can subtract multiples of 360. So in this case, for example, when you are 602 degrees minus 360, that would be 242. If you are 727 minus 720 is 7. So you can subtract multiples of 360 and write the actual bearing, or leave it as they are, because they make no difference. Sine of 727 degrees is the same as sine of 7 degrees. Cos of 727 degrees is the same as cos of 7 degrees, because all we've done, we've got 360 twice, round twice. So that's all you have to do. Start from the first to the last, make it say 0 degrees, or choose what you've been given, and then simply add the angles at the next one, add 180. Add the angles, add 180. Add the angle at the next station, add 180, and you will have the bearings for each traverse. When you're writing this one, if you get confused where you are along the line, draw these division lines. Start from first to the last, 1 to 6, and then 1 to 2. And then opposite is 2 to 1. And then the 2 goes there, becomes 2 to the 3. Opposite, 3 to 2. 3 goes there, 3 to 4. Then 4 to 3. So you see these are the same. Same number goes there, same number goes there, and same number goes to the start of the next one. Whatever you there goes to the next one. But otherwise it's 1 to 2, 2 to 1, and then 2 to 3, 3 to 2, and then 3 to 4, 4 to 3, and then 4 to 5, 5 to 4. Have a go yourself, create your own traverse, write your own numbers. First of all, before you do that, you need to check your total angle that they add up. And the procedure is the sum of all internal angles equals to 2n minus 4 times 90. In this case, because it's 6 stations, 2 times 6 is 12, 12 minus 4 is 8, 8 times 90 is 720. This is what the total angles should be, and if we add them up, we get 720, because I made sure they are 720 for this exercise. Usually they aren't, usually they are because of degrees, minutes and seconds, they're not going to add up 720, you need to adjust that, but that's a different exercise. I hope you've enjoyed this lesson, I hope you have a go at it and try yourself. You can get any surveying book, and in any surveying book you'll find examples of traverse with the angles given, and try to see if you can work out the bearing yourself. Thank you for watching this video, and you can subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos as they are published. Thank you.